Hi, my name's Theo.
And I'm Tom.
Welcome to Day in the Life of an NJ Moore Field Guide College student.
Most of our days start with a 4:45 wake-up call, followed by a coffee.
Or two.
We leave the tent at around 5 a.m. and make sure to zip it up completely to avoid the ever-present danger of a vervet monkey raid.
The coffee station is the first port of call, and the race to down a scalding mug before the game drive leaves provides good entertainment.
We're usually greeted by animals as soon as we leave the gate, as elephants and buffalo are frequent visitors to our border fence.
Some grass or something. I don't know, Theo thinks he's artsy. Even on short drives, the backdrop is spectacular, and I guess the rhinos are pretty cool too.
Half an hour into our drive, we hear over the radio that a lioness has been spotted on the western plains.
Wildlife photography has become quite a competitive sport amongst the group as we all try to get the best animal shot.
In a picture-taking sense, of course.
This lioness has recently had a litter of cubs, so we were happy to see her enjoying a good meal.
Watching her for a while gave us all quite the appetite, and we decided a breakfast of our own was in order.
We interrupt this nature film for a quick culinary masterclass.
Fueled by 3 to 4 coffees at this point, we feel ready to study. Either a morning lecture occurs, or some private study occupies our mornings.
Some of us have other priorities, however.
Good time management allows for plenty of downtime during the day, and the recreational room, otherwise affectionately dubbed the Rec, is an arena to display plenty of signs of a misspent youth, with games such as pool or darts.
There's a real sense of community in camp, and its upkeep is the responsibility of all its inhabitants. Duty teams will wash the car, prepare hot boxes, or otherwise look remotely busy at this stage.
Coffee, again.
You get the gist.
Here we see our supreme leader, or head trainer, Mike, in his natural habitat, giving us a lecture. Our lectures take anything from 40 to 60 minutes and cover one of the 14 modules of theory required for our course.
Taking the laundry back. Please note, the equipment seen in this clip does not come included in your stay. Although those of us crazy enough to go running can make use of a very hilly terrain at 1100 meters altitude.
And now an improvised dance break for your viewing pleasure.
Lunch and more crepes.
Depending on the day, there may be a second lecture in the afternoon or some downtime, but we thought we'd give the people what they really want, a cheetah. Maratapa Reserve is known for its ease of cheetah sightings, as well as many other big game.
Nevertheless, this was our first sighting after a few weeks.
A need for some more promotional content dictated the quality acting you see now, and upon arrival of the second car, we made room.
Wait, they're gonna come forward.
Afternoon tea is a time to catch up on the day's events and sample some staples of the local cuisine. Rusks, sportingly modelled by Theo here.
A black-back jackal. Zebra in the sunset and a short drive back to camp.
More food. Sitting in a game vehicle is tiring work.
A normal evening will see these young bulls putting into effect their hours of practice on the pool table. Finally, some campfire stories and stargazing caps off our day, and snoring joins the chorus of nighttime sounds heard around the camp.